You want to see how to pour a perfectly level floor using self-leveler? We're going to show you right now. Welcome to our basement bathroom. This area is going to have the vanity and it's going to have the toilet. And over in this section here, it's going to be a curbless shower. So the very first thing I'm going to do is I want to level off this section, which any basement you'll find in the foundation is not level at all. So I'm going to use a self-leveling product and I'm going to show you exactly how to do it. So the first thing that I'm going to do is I want to create a water dam around this room. When you're pouring self-level, the self-leveling concrete is very, very thin and it will find its way to escape anywhere. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to spray foam all the cracks underneath all of these 2x4s. And I've put this temporary 2x4 here to act as a curb so that I'm only leveling this area here. But the spray foam is going to act like waterproofing so that when I pour the self-leveling cement, it all stays in one place and has time to cure and level off. Okay, so I'm going to let that expanding foam harden up, and then once it's already hard, I'm going to take a knife, I'm going to cut it back, and then I'll pour some self-leveling cement. Okay, so if you look around, you can see that I've let the spray foam dry, and I cut it back with a knife, and it's difficult to see, but it's sealed underneath the framing now. So when I pour myself level, we're not going to get any seepage underneath all these. Now, like I said before, some of this stuff is just superficial. This curb piece right here is going to come out afterwards, and we're going to have a nice level line, and this door frame is eventually going to get cut back, but I really just want to make this level flat here right now. So the next thing that we're going to do is I've already vacuumed it up, and I've scuff sanded it in a few spots, but we're going to want to put on a concrete primer. Now, what this stuff is it's just going to make sure that it improves the adhesion and seals up some of the porous bits of it. So I've already gone ahead and I've diluted this with water because we do have some porous concrete in here. So all I'm going to do now is I'm going to pour it down. I'm going to smooth it out with a brush and we're going to let that dry before we pour our self-level. Okay, the main reason we're doing this here is because you can see that this concrete floor is completely out of level and it's not flat at all. When you hold up this smaller level on one side, you'll see that there's a big hump in the middle of the floor. And with this longer level, you'll see that there's a big dip underneath the middle of it here. And then when you look at the actual level dot, you'll see that it's way off. By doing self-level on this whole floor, we're going to have a tileable space that's going to be flat and level, which will make it a breeze to tile on. We've put the primer on and now we've let that cure. And the next thing we're going to do is we're going to mix up our self-level. Make sure you read on the back of every label to see exactly how much water they want you to use per bag. And another thing is read the square footage that bag's going to be able to cover for you. The last thing you want to do is not have enough. So make sure you mix up enough so that you can pool this whole area, make it nice and flat to the height that you want. Let's get started. We don't have a lot of time. Once this stuff gets going, it can dry really quickly. Again, check the bag you're using. We're using the stuff from Home Depot. Can dry quickly, so make sure you've got everything ready. So by the time you mix it all together, you're all set to pour it, because you don't want it to dry too quickly and then have a line that you can't smooth it out. You really want to have this stuff all ready before you go. Before I pour this concrete in this bucket, another good tip is to keep some water. Put the amount of water that you're going to need in the bucket first. That way you won't get that dry clumps at the bottom. You got to be scooping up and mixing with the water. It'll keep the dust down a little bit and it'll be easier to mix. Now you pour it down. Okay, everything should be nice and level now. We're gonna let that dry and then we can show you with a level, make sure everything's looking perfect. But so far so good. We'll clean up our buckets and 4 hours later, we'll check on. So you can see that the floor is now nice and dry and it is level and it is flat. You saw before how there was a big hump in the middle and there was dips and dives and it wasn't level at all. Now it's perfectly flat and it's perfectly level. So we're gonna be doing a lot more with this shower pan behind you, but we just wanted to show you a quick way to self-level a little space. Now that this is nice and level, we can work off of that for the rest of the bathroom.